casts, and I'm gonna do this the same way, so you could manage it with a TI-83 or TI-84. We're gonna go to Scratchpad, get the graphing up. We already have the entry window open. One of our graphs was 4x plus 12. Hit enter. Hit the tab button again to open up that entry line, and we have x cubed, arrow over to get to the exponent, plus 3x squared. Enter. All right, well, I can't see the intersection of these two graphs. I'm going to go to Menu, go to Window Zoom, and do Window Settings. We're just going to close up that window a little bit, maybe -7, and I'll X max of +7. And we went low enough. Let's let the Y max be 24. Ah, there we go. Now I'm not going to find both of these areas. If you understand how to do one, you can do both. So let's find this bigger area here. Now, we're going to find the area below the linear function and between the intersection points of -2 and +2. And then we're going to do the same thing with the cubic function and subtract them. So we're going to need to first find the intersection points, assuming we don't already have those. So we're going to go to Menu, Analyze Graph, find the intersection. Calculator will ask you for the lower and upper bound. I'm using my touchpad, of course, but you'll be using this pad here on your calculator. And there's our intersection of -2, 4. And then finally, again, Menu, Analyze Graph, use the touchpad, go to intersection, lower bound, upper bound, and then there's their other intersection point of 220. All right, so I want to find the area below the linear function of 4x plus 12 between these values. Menu, analyze graph, let's find the integral. The calculator will ask you what graph. We want to do this one, so you have to do this one graph at a time. Lower bound, you can just type in the number. So I'm going to go to -2, and there's a little box opening up here. Enter. And you'll see that it's actually, with the Nspire, will show me the area below the curve as I move my upper bound around. But we want that set to a concrete value of 2. So I'm going to hit 2. There's a little window opening up for me. And we have that area of 48. And I'm writing that down on my piece of paper. Now we're going to find the area below the cubic function. So again, Menu, Analyze Graph, Integral. Which graph? Well, I want to use the cubic one this time. Lower bound. Again, -2. Oh, and I'm using my keyboard, but you'd be good hitting negative here, 2. And enter, locking that up. Did I get that? Yes. Okay, upper bound. Then I want to, again, have that be a value of 2. So just hit 2 and enter. And that lower area, or the area below the cubic function, between that and the x-axis was 16, and if you subtract those, 48 minus 16 is an area of 32, which was almost the complete answer, I believe, between the area of those two graphs, because this is such a small area. Now, this is a CAS version, which stands for Computer Algebra System. I could come over here to the, you're probably hitting the tab button here, but to toggle between the two views, I can go to Menu, Calculus, the integral. My lower bound again was -2. My upper bound was +2. And here I can just get the answer of 32. Hopefully get the same answer. And I can actually just type in the subtraction of those two functions. Now, again, the linear function was first, which was 4x plus 12. Minus, and then the other function has a lot of terms in it, so I'm going to use parentheses. That cubic function was x cubed plus 3x squared. And we're going to integrate that with respect to x. And voila, we have the answer of 32 again. Now that was just one of the two areas. You have to find the other one with a similar fashion and add those two together to get the same answer that I got in my video. All right, so thank you for watching. Let's get on to the next example.